to just being the bodyguard that is completely blocking anybody moving into the opposing side of the base. Perfect Halo, hits the shot as well. Shooter dead again. This boy cannot get out the death screen, unfortunately. The body whack does come. He tags him up. Can he get this kill, please? God, no! Killing spree as well there for Snakebite. What an, a massive amount of work he's doing over here on Elbow. He's just been a complete nuisance.
So, so impressive there from Snakebite. I mean, Royal 2 in the, with the previous sniper only had 3 bullets to work with.
Please kill him.
Snakebite only had 5 bullets to work with. And honestly, 2 captures back-to-back in the same vein here. It's very possible that that could happen for Tox. Snakebite doing work on the Elbow. His teammate, I believe that is Lethal running flag. Falcated, he has to push up right here. I think this is game. That's such a well...
All right, you watch the clip. Tox versus Oceanic Halo 5 MLG Columbus in a game-ending flag cap that was led by Snakebite's immaculate control of the blue bend. But how did he do that? I'm going to replay the clip. We're going to analyze each moment critically, and the first one's going to kick off really quick right here. The flag cap by Frosty, Snakebite controlling blue bend. He does a spring jump up to here, and then he's going to aim the sniper, and there's a couple things I want to talk about. So first off, the spring jump. You can spring jump up to that pedestal. You might not have known that, and he did a scoreboard spring jump as well, which is 100% consistent. If you can master the scoreboard spring jump, you'll get that spring jump down perfectly and nail that high-level Halo tech. The next part here, though, that's super important is he aims the sniper out at blue bend. Now, you're going to see in a sec, he's going to adjust the sniper to head-level positioning and wait with the scope until the player walks into his scope. That's a big thing in Halo is if you can predict head-level and perfectly position your reticle beforehand, then the player can walk into it based off of your prediction. You can get the easy headshot. Watch this. He had it already in the head-level right before he walked into it. All he has to do is pull the trigger, fire the shot with the perfect timing. Shooter's gonna get taken out. He's gonna dive up to blue bend. You'll see behind him, he's getting pressured by an opposing player. He tries to take advantage with the clamber. While he's clambering, he tries to take advantage by sniping him. Let's back up for 1 second, though. You'll notice he doesn't have a thrust when he backs up. So he missed his shot. He got pushed backwards. This player, Falcated, is going to thrust forward, which you're going to see right here. Falcated using his thrust. In this situation with Snakebite, he's one shot. He's got one snipe bullet left in the chamber. In order to make this work, he has to wait for the last possible second. If you got a sniper, you want to no-scope somebody, wait for the moment that they thrust. You're going to see right here, Falcated's thrusting to try and take advantage of this opportunity. Snakebite, just getting his thrust back a second ago, is going to counter-thrust immediately to dodge, and then at the last possible second, he's going to whip that snipe after the thrust in order to hit him with that body shot. Now, it's hard to explain how exactly that works, but Snakebite's a high sense player. I've seen him have sensitivities over 6 sense, so you know what he's gonna wait for that last possible moment in that perfect reaction to swing and hit the shot. See that right there? He swings, nails him with the body shot. The next important part here, backs up, and he's going to move forward. Once again, reticle positioning is huge. When he's moving forward on the bend here, instead of going around the bend and possibly putting himself at risk of other players spawning in blue base, instead he's going to walk immediately downwards, and this is all down to reticle positioning and reaction. He's got to perfectly place his reticle. You can see he's already setting it up as to where he thinks the player is going to be, and he has to immediately react, and this comes with just high-level play and experience. Snakebite's reactions are on point. He's going to take him out with that headshot right there. Move back up to blue bend. I want you to also take note of how he pressures blue bend. It's important that he stays on this blue bend the whole time because he can continue to add pressure, allow his teammates to continue to collapse and grab that flag cap. So don't want to overexert yourself. You want to stay on this bend and keep applying pressure to the last moment. Look how he jumps up here though. See the little ledge that he jumped on? That is huge to take advantage of. You don't even really need to crouch jump to get up there, but if you jump up on that ledge, you have cover, you can crouch and stay undercover while applying pressure at the same time. So it's a good way to get up onto the blue bend safely. You're going to see him do that. He misses his shots though, backs down. Risky clamber is going to back down again, let his teammate collapse with him. So you can see he's not pushing up, he's taking his time. Frosty comes up on the collapse. This is the biggest thing right here about his pressure though, is he jumps up, fires 2 shots into the back of the blue cave there to suppress that opponent, and then tapping buttons pushes up. Instead of thrusting forward and pushing in and attacking, instead he's going to thrust back to the pedestal, back to safety, cut off those angles from blue base, and just focus his attention into tapping buttons. And tapping buttons right now is focused on Frosty. That means that Snakebite has an opportunity to put in serious damage. Watch how he holds his ground. This is huge. When he's standing on that pedestal, he doesn't walk off forward. He doesn't get scared and walk off backwards. He strafes lightly to the left and the right, holds his ground, and focuses on his shot to nail those shots. That is so huge. You don't want to crumble. You got to stay confident in this situation. Watch. The light strafe, staying right where he needs to apply the pressure. He puts that pressure in, takes out those opponents. The flag's going to get grabbed and run, and now we have a long-distance battle. It's hard to say how exactly you win these battles. Snakebite, of course, predicting that players are going to spawn on the blue cave. He had thrown a nade already over to blue cave. He's jumping up to pressure on catwalk now. Now, in these long-range battles, the biggest thing I can say is if you're going to scope in, understand that you're going to be de-scoped if you're fighting an opponent in this distance. If this opponent is a good player, Denoxide, obviously an amazing player, he will probably land some of his shots and you will probably be de-scoped. So you have to know in your mind before that fight that you will get de-scoped. If you're clicking in the right stick to scope, that means that you should not manually click the stick again to get out of your scope. Just let him de-scope you, keep your scope stable and keep it strong, and just make sure that you make those slight adjustments in order to re-scope and snap back on him. And don't worry about de-scoping yourself. Just know that he's going to de-scope for you because he's going to apply that pressure. So just know that. Don't get freaked out and get flustered and throw your aimer around. Let him de-scope you. Snap it back in on his face the best you can. Snakebite, though, doing his job, applies the pressure that he needs to. Denoxide is stuck and focused there. He doesn't get the kill, but it doesn't matter. It's too late. The flag's going to get run around. They're going to get the cap and seal the deal on the game. And there's the victory and the analysis on today's Halo analysis. I still haven't figured out the title for this, but thank you guys for checking it out, and I'll see you around.